Mike Williams, speaking of horses, we're here at the Equus Film Festival 2017, right here in Manhattan. We're at the Helen Mills Theater. We're not far from Penn Station. But I'm very happy to have as my guest Annette Van Trip. And she's from Holland. You are a film producer. And the film that just ran here at the festival was on the Amish. Tell us your inspiration. Why did you pick this topic? What drove you to it?
Now, first of all, I think I was inspired when I was very young by the movie of Harrison Ford. It's called On Foot, Kidnapped.
Witness.
Witness, oh yeah, sorry. Witness, a great movie.
Yes, it is.
Well, I'm a filmmaker related to documentaries about horses, but not only horses. As you watch the movie about the Amish, there was something I would like to show as well. How do they keep up in modern times? That's the whole idea.
Mm-hmm.
And then I find out in Holland, there is a guy named Wim in the north of Groningen, and he was doing business with the Amish people in Grebel, harness horses. And he sold them, and then I think, well, that's maybe a good opportunity to join him and see if I can get, as the horse using as a vehicle, to get into this into their world.
Right.
And it worked out very well. So I sent, first year I sent a researcher with small camera, and we wanted to film a keuring, which is a Dutch word after all, keuring.
Yeah, right. Which do you do the keuring when you approve Friesian status? Mm-hmm. For even there, they all have to be tested and meet all the criteria, which is the keuring process.
And every year there's a big keuring. And the famous horse of Wim was, he sold to the Amish, was participating, and that was the whole idea to get into this community and see how they live in this modern times, because it's very hard, humans know, to keep it up with computers, cell phones.
It's very hard to stay removed from that, and that's what they try to do.
But it's interesting. I interviewed a grandma, and she says, we are responsible for the third and fourth generation.
Mm-hmm.
And she's very worried that she will go to hell when she sees her grandchildren, even with them. Cell phones. They don't have a cell phone, but you see this Joe, the owner of Colonist, who bought a horse of Wim, and he's not driving a car himself. He has a driver. He's not emailing, but his driver is having an iPad. Now, okay, guess what? After all, this I made this movie, film, documentary. I get a reaction from Grebel. They all have seen it. And they got a lot of comments. But what's interesting about these Dutch harness horses is they're luxury horses, because, trust me, they pay a lot of money for this brilliant horse, Patijn.
Right.
He unfortunately passed away before the film was showed in Holland.
Mm.
He died. Yeah, a colleague. So this guy who loves his horse more than his wife. I must be very, this Patijn died on the same day as my father did.
Well, it's, we're really happy you did the film. I'm always intrigued with the Amish and how they handle their lifestyle and stay out of, as much as they can.
It's impossible.
But it's impossible.
It's impossible.
You know?
Let me tell you one story. When we arrived there, you've got a certain idea. My son was, he's 24, was the sound engineer. And he was driving a car. And as soon as we came upon the yard of Joe Zier, the grandma came out. Ah, can you drive me to the $1 shop? I have to buy to get a Christmas Christmas present. I think that probably ordered it online. So this was our first, my God, is this really true?
And also in the documentary, there is a scene that I'm interviewing one of the Amish.
I'm starting the interview, and then his phone rings, and then you hear his wife, I didn't know that by the time, and she says, I don't want you to be interviewed, so we quit.
Annette, thank you very much, I really appreciate
it. You're welcome.
And what's the name of the film again?
Amish 2.0.
Amish 2.0. All right, we encourage you to look at it. We're speaking of horses. We are here at Equus Film Festival.